Hare Krishna, welcome to devotees. Thank you so much for joining us. We're back here again, and it's again my very, very great honor and fortune to welcome His Grace Hari Parshad Prabhu again. Hare Krishna, Hare Parshad Prabhu, thank you so much for joining us again today.
Hare Krishna, my pranams. Jai Srila Prabhupada. Thank you so much for kindly inviting me here and honoring me. It's a great honor to be invited by the GBC SPT to speak on this wonderful topic of Ras Panchadhyayi.
Thank you so much, Prabhu. So like I was mentioning yesterday, Hari Parshad Prabhu will be discussing the five chapters of the Rasa Dance, the Rasa Panchadhyayi. And he covered very systematically and beautifully the first chapter, which is the 29th chapter. And today he'll be taking the next two chapters. I recommend everyone to please take time to hear the first chapter. With the GBC SPT, it has been our attempt to systematically study the 10th canto. And now we have reached the Rasa Dance chapters. So Hari Parshad Prabhu, without further ado, I request you to please shed light on these two chapters. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much, Govinda Priya Mataji, for kindly inviting me here, introducing me. And I would once again like to thank all the devotees who are kindly present here today. And before we begin our presentation, as usual, I would like to begin with Mangalacharan. Mangalacharan, that is auspicious invocations. And these auspicious invocations will help us to ensure that there are no difficulties in our program. There are no such events which will obstruct the success of the program. So that is the purpose of the Mangalacharan. So dear devotees, let's begin Mangalacharan. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Soyam Rupah Kadamahyam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yutapada Kamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Vitamscha Namaha Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Shri Mate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Nitinamine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Desha Tarine Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratvishaya Namaha E Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda ki jai, Nithai Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol. So dear devotees, welcome once again to this, the second part of this three-part presentation on the Ras Panchadhyayi. Today we'll be discussing the contents of chapter 30 and chapter 31. But before we begin, I would like to start with a quote from Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada Uvacha. Prabhupada says, this book Incarnation of the Lord gives much fascinating information of the transcendental pastimes of the Lord, like his Rasalila with the spiritual cowherd damsels of Vrajabhumi. This specific pastime of the Lord has a special significance, because anyone who properly learns about this particular pastime of the Lord will certainly be dissuaded from mundane sex desire and be placed on the path of sublime devotional service to the Lord. So Srila Prabhupada says in this purport to 1st Canto, 18th chapter, verse 31, that anyone who properly learns this pastime will be freed from the disease of the heart, that is lust. Of course, he is speaking about the same thing that Srila Shukadeva Goswami will speak at the end of the Rasa Panchadhyay. So he is rephrasing Srila Shukadeva Goswami. But this is the faith that we have in Rasa Panchadhyay. It is a superior form of love as compared to material love. And for this reason, it is capable of extinguishing all material lust which is rooted in the heart. But dear devotees, even though Srila Prabhupada may encourage us, there may still be some individuals who may not be sahriday or like-minded. And the sahriday individuals may think that this speaker who is currently speaking today, that is myself, will spoil the taste of the previous acharyas. He will spoil the message of the previous acharyas by his faulty speaking. So dear devotees, there may be some who are not sahriday, like-minded, who may think like this. But if there are such individuals, I would like to say something. That disqualification is my qualification. In the 13th century, on the western coast of India, there appeared a poet named Sri Jaidev. This Jaidev Kavi was different from Sri Jaidev Goswami. But this Sri Jaidev, he composed a very brilliant book on poetics. His book's name is Chandra Alokah, The Brilliance of the Moon. And when he was sitting down to compose his book, there were many people who were not sahriday, who were not favorable to him. And they said, you know, the previous acharyas of poetry have already written so much. By you writing anything new, you are only going to spoil whatever they have done. So when Sri Jaidev was writing his book, at that point of time, he knew that there were some people who were not favorable to him. So at the beginning of his work, Chandra Aloka, he composed a verse which is as follows. Na shankaniyamete sham matametena dushyate किंतु चक्षुर मृगाक्षीणाम कज्जलेन एव भूष्यते. श्री जयदेव सेज न आशंकनीयम. ओ डाउटर्स, डू नॉट हैव डाउट दैट एतेषां मतम, द राइटिंग्स ऑफ द प्रीवियस आचार्यस, एतेन दुष्यते, विल बी स्पॉइल्ड बाय मी स्पीकिंग अबाउट इट. प्लीज डोंट हैव दीज डाउट्स दैट बाय माय स्पीकिंग ऑन दीज टॉपिक्स the writings of the previous acharyas will be spoiled. Kintu chakshur mrigakshinam kajjaleneva bhushyate. And he gives an example. Chakshur mrigakshinam. Chakshu means eyes and mrigakshi means doe-eyed ladies. Beautiful ladies, they have beautiful eyes. And these beautiful eyes, they appear already, they are very beautiful. But if you apply one very useless substance to those eyes, that useless substance is kajal, mascara. If you apply that. So even though kajal is a useless substance, but when it is applied to the eyes of beautiful girls, those eyes become even more beautiful. Similarly, Sri Jayadev said that although my realizations may be as useless as dark kajal, because you apply kajal any place, you apply it on the wall is spoiled. You know, you apply it on the floor is spoiled. So you apply it on paper, paper is spoiled. Anywhere you apply kajal, that thing gets spoiled. But if that kajal is applied on the beautiful eyes of beautiful women, then those eyes become even more beautiful. Similarly, my realizations may be as worthless as dark kajal, but I am applying them on the beautiful doe-eyed literatures of the previous acharyas. And the purpose is to make this literature appear even more beautiful. So this, dear devotees, is the mood of today's presentation. The audience should kindly not doubt that the opinions of these previous great acharyas will be spoiled by these explanations of mine. In fact, their opinions will be highlighted and glorified even more. Just as beautiful doe-eyed ladies appear even more beautifully decorated when a useless black substance named kajal is applied on their eyes. So this, dear devotees, is the qualification of being disqualified. So moving ahead, in yesterday's discussion on chapter 29, we saw that Krishna disappeared. He became antarhita. And we saw the various takes on the word antarhita by the previous acharyas. So Krishna disappeared from the Rasalila. And what happened after that is described in chapter 30. So at the beginning of chapter 30, Sri Shukadeva Goswami says, Sri Shuka Uvacha, Antarhite Bhagavati Sahasaiva Vrajangana Atapyam Stam Achakshana Karanya Iva Yuthapam. Sri Shukadeva Goswami said, Sri Shuka, Sri means Sri Yukta Shuka. Sri Sanatana Goswami says, Sri Shuka means Sri Yukta Shuka, which means Shukadeva Goswami endowed with all opulence, all beauty, all knowledge, all renunciation. Sri Shuka Uvacha. So Sri Shukadeva Goswami said, Antarhite Bhagavati, when Bhagavan became Antarhita, he disappeared. Or in other words, he decided to bestow inner benefit on the gopis. Sahasaiva, suddenly it all happened. Prajangana, all the ladies of Raja, atapyams, they started burning inside. Why? Tam achakshana, because they could not perceive him in front of their eyes. And how were they burning? Karanya iva yuthapam. So just as female elephants, they burn in separation when they are not able to see a male elephant, their partner. In a similar way, they also started burning. So this is the translation. Shukadev Goswami said, when Lord Krishna disappeared so suddenly, the gopis felt great sorrow at losing sight of him, like a group of female elephants who have lost their mate. So we have already seen the various meanings of antarhite yesterday. And these gopis, when they started crying, when they became so agitated at heart, at that time the condition of the gopis is described in the Bhagavatam. But before this condition of the gopis is described in the Bhagavatam, commentators ask a very important question. Why did the gopis become so distressed at heart? So this question is answered by the devotee commentator, Sri Hari Suri, who gives a beautiful verse in his commentary. He says, Lokeshu labhyam avisheshamapiha vastu यातं यदि क्वचिदपि क्षणमात्रमेव संभ्रांतधीर्भवति तेन पुमान् किमत्र चित्रं स्त्रियः प्रभुकृते विपिने तथा सन्। सो ही सेज लोकेषु लभ्यम् अविशेषमपि इह वस्तु, लोकेषु इन दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड लभ्यम अविशेषम, इफ इवन एन इनसिग्निफिकेंट वस्तु ऑब्जेक्ट, इवन एन इनसिग्निफिकेंट ऑब्जेक्ट इन दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड, यातम यदि क्वचित अपि क्षणमात्रमेव, इवन फॉर अ मोमेंट इफ दैट इनसिग्निफिकेंट ऑब्जेक्ट इज गेन्ड एंड देन लॉस्ट, इफ यू गेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑल्दो इट इज इनसिग्निफिकेंट एंड क्षणमात्रम फॉर अ मोमेंट ऑल्सो इफ इट इज लॉस्ट, संभ्रांत धीर भवति तेन पुमान, ह्यूमंस बिकम एक्सट्रीमली डिस्ट्रेस्ड इन देयर हार्ट। किमत्र चित्रम, सो व्हाट इज सरप्राइजिंग दैट स्त्रियः प्रभु कृते विपिने तथा सन्। सो व्हेन द गोपीज लॉस्ट द लव ऑफ देयर लाइफ, द क्रेस्ट ज्यूल ऑफ ऑल लवर्स इन द यूनिवर्स फॉर सच अ लॉन्ग ड्यूरेशन, सो देन व्हाट इज द सरप्राइजिंग फैक्ट हियर दैट दे बिकेम सो एजिटेटेड एट हार्ट, because ahead they're going to cry loudly, they're going to sing, they're going to express their feelings of mahabhav. So all the reason for that is because they found something and then they lost it. Sri Harishuri wants to say here indirectly that if they would have never found him, if they would have never attained him, then the distress of losing him would not be so much. But the distress is greater because they attained him and after attaining him, they lost him. That makes the pain of separation much greater. So here is the translation. In this world, when even a small object is attained and then lost, it causes immense anxiety to humans. Thus, it is not surprising that these ladies became maddened in the forest after losing the love of their lives. So this maddened condition of the gopis is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam 30th chapter. As the cowherd women remembered Lord Krishna, their hearts were overwhelmed by his movements and loving smiles. Because his external disappeared, so he is now manifested inside. You see, as Harishuri said, antarhite, he is going to bestow inner benefit. And inner benefit can only be bestowed when he is present within their hearts. So Krishna manifested himself within their hearts. This condition is known as viraha, separation. So they were overwhelmed by his movements and loving smiles. So moving ahead, his playful glances and enchanting talks, and by the many other pastimes he would enjoy with them. Thus absorbed in thoughts of Krishna, the Lord of Rama, the gopis began acting out his various transcendental pastimes. Because the beloved gopis were absorbed in thoughts of their beloved Krishna, their bodies imitated his way of moving and smiling, his way of beholding them, his speech and his other distinctive features. Deeply immersed in thinking of him and maddened by remembering his pastimes, they declared to one another, "I am Krishna." So dear devotees, what is happening is they were so absorbed in thinking of Krishna that this absorption led many of them to a feeling of non-difference with Krishna's mood. And they started saying, "I am Krishna, I am Krishna." Shukadev Goswami is also losing track of the sequence here. Actually, the imitation by the gopis of the various pastimes is going to come slightly later. But Shukadev Goswami starts speaking about it in the very beginning, and then he will speak about something else, and then he will again come back to this where they are imitating his pastimes. So right now he is speaking about Krishna, the gopis imitating the pastimes of Krishna. Then he will suddenly change track and he will say the gopis were searching for him and asking the various trees. And then he will say that after they failed to get a reply from the various trees and creepers, they started imitating his pastimes. So obviously, the sequence is out of order, and this is because Sri Shukadev Goswami is experiencing ecstasy. And Shukadev Goswami is also in samadhi, he is in trance, and in his samadhi avastha he is explaining all these things. So moving ahead, Srimad Bhagavatam describes singing out, singing loudly of Krishna. They search for him throughout the Vrindavan forest like a band of mad women. Now the thing is, they are not yet singing. They will start singing in the next chapter, in the Gopi Gita. But Shukadev Goswami's sequence is broken here. The Rasa Leela broke the sequence of narration of Shukadev Goswami. They even ask the trees about him, who as the super soul is present inside and outside of all created things, just like the sky. So here the Bhagavatam says, you know, they ask the trees about him, who as the super soul is present inside and outside of all created things. Actually, the Ishopanishad says, Tad dure tadvantike. The fifth mantra of Ishopanishad says, he is dura, he is far, yet tadu antike, he is very close to us. This mantra was fixed in the heart of the gopis, that although he is far, tad dure, tadu antike, but he is very near to us. He is hiding somewhere near. At this point, Sri Hari Suri says, Eka eva prabhu prapter upayo bhuvaneshuyat. He says, Ek eva prabhu prapte upayo bhuvaneshu yat vastu matre tad adhyasa ityakurvam stathaivata. So he says, Ek eva prabhu prapte upayo. So there is only one well-known way of attaining the Lord in this world. And what is that? Krishna himself has said in Bhagavad Gita, Yo mam pashyati sarvatra, he who sees me everywhere. Sarvam chamai pashyati, sees everything in me. So the gopis began to see Krishna everywhere. Vastu matre tadadhyasa ityakurvam sathaivata. Therefore the gopis started seeing, looking for Krishna everywhere, seeing Krishna everywhere. So in this way, the gopis were looking for Krishna and they started asking all the trees and creepers. Dear devotees, at least 25 trees were requested by the gopis. And these 25 trees, each one of them has a different name. I will try to list the names of these 25 trees. And the acharyas have given realizations on the names of each and every tree. So our Gaudiya Vaishnava acharyas say that the gopis first asked the Ashwatth tree. Oh, Ashwatha. Ashwatha is the people tree, also known as Ficus religiosa. Oh, Ashwatha, please tell us where the son of Nanda Maharaj has gone. They will never directly utter the name of, you know, Krishna here. They will say son of Nanda Maharaj, the younger brother of Balaram, and so on and so forth. Because they consider him the Lord and Master of their lives, so they don't want to utter his name directly. They asked Ashwatha, O Ashwatha, where is Krishna? The commentators such as Sri Hari Suri says that the gopis were thinking, Ashwatha, in the Bhagavad Gita you are described as Samsara Rupam. Samsara Rupam means the personification, the personified form of the material world. O Ashwatha, if this is true, then kindly show us some sar rupam. Sam means complete. Sar means essence. Rupam means beauty. Please show us some sar rupam, the complete essence of all beauty, that is Bhagavan Shri Krishna. So Ashwatha, if you are some sar rupam, show us some sar rupam. Then they ask the plaksha tree. Is another variation of fig. So this is the white fig tree. So they asked the plaksha tree. And they asked the nyagrodha banyan tree. So our acharyas, Gaudiya Vaishnava acharyas, say that Ashwatha is a representative of Vishnu, Krishna. Vishnu Laksha is a representative of Brahma. Nyagrodha is a representative of Shiva. So they asked Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh by asking Ashwatha, Plaksha and Nyagrodha. Sri Hari Suri says that Nyagrodha is the banyan tree. The banyan tree is like a big yogi with big matted logs growing down. It grows high up in the sky, just like the yogi who wants to go high up in the sky. The Nyagrodha, the banyan tree, tolerates harsh weathers just like the yogi tolerates harsh weathers. O Nyagrodha, if even after all this, you were unable to find the Supreme Lord. O yogi, if even after all this, you were unable to find the Supreme Lord, then what's the use of asking you? So in this way, they asked these three trees. These three trees are also very high. So they asked the highest trees because these trees can see far away in the forest. But when these trees did not reply, of course these trees will not reply. Because the gopis are experiencing unmad, transcendental madness. So these trees and no other trees will respond, but the gopis will still ask. When these trees did not reply, then they asked the trees which do not grow so high, but some other trees such as Kurabaka. Kurabaka is porcupine flower tree. So they started asking the trees which have fragrant flowers. And they asked the Ashoka tree. Ashoka is known as Saraka Ashoka in botanical language. So this Ashoka tree they asked. Then they asked the Nagakeshara tree, which is known as Ceylon Ironwood. And they asked the Punnaga tree. And they also asked the Champaka tree. Champaka is a common fragrant flower. So all these fragrant flower trees they asked. And the acharyas have given realizations on all these trees. So like Sri Hari Suri says about, you know, Ashoka. I'll give some examples. Ashoka, he says, you are Ashoka, Ashoka, without any shoka, lamentation. Why don't you also make us Ashoka, without any lamentation? Then Naga Keshara. Naga Keshara is actually also known as Naga. So, oh, Naga tree, you know, it is said in literatures that the Supreme Lord rests under a Naga. So, you are also Naga. Naga means serpent. So, it is said in Shastra that the Supreme Lord rests besides a Naga or a serpent. So, you are also Naga. Please tell us if the Supreme Lord is residing somewhere near you. Then there is Pumnaga and there is Champaka. So they asked all these trees. Finally, they asked Tulsi, who is very dear to Bhagavan. And the commentators say, how surprising. Usually Tulsi takes shelter at the lotus feet of the Lord. And the gopis are asking if the Supreme Lord has taken shelter at the feet of Tulsi. This is certainly divine madness, nothing else. And they asked some other creepers, such as Malati. So they asked all the fragrant jasmine flowers. So all the jasmine flower, all varieties of jasmine flowers, such as Malati, Dati, Yuthika. Yuthika is also known as Juhi in Hindi. Pallika. So all these they asked. So these various varieties of jasmine were asked by the gopis. Have you seen Krishna somewhere? Then the gopis did not receive a reply from them. So they asked various fruit giving trees. The first tree they asked is Amra, mango tree. Because Amra, amongst all fruits which give rasa, Amra is Rasa Shekhar, the king of all rasa-giving fruits. O Amra, why don't you bestow the king of all rasas, Madhurya Rasa, upon us? Then they asked the rasala, which is another variety of a juicy mango. And Sri Hari Suri says, O rasala, O juicy mango, you are Gopika Nandanaha. Gopika Nandanaha means, Nandanaha means joy giving to the Gopikas. Hidden meaning, you are Gopika Anandakaha. Go means cow, Pika means the cuckoos. Anandakaha means joy giving. You give joy to Go and Pika, to the cows and cuckoos and parrots. So, oh, Gopika Anandakaha. Please tell us where Krishna is, otherwise you will become Gopika Nandakaha. The third meaning here is Gopika means gopis. Nandaka. Nandaka is the name of Krishna's sword. So you will become Gopika Nandakaha. You will become the sword of Krishna which slaughtered the gopis. If you don't tell us where Krishna is. So decide, what do you want to become? Gopika Nandakaha, the joy giver of the gopis? Do you want to become Gopika Nandakaha, the joy giver of cows and cuckoos and parrots? Or by not telling us where Krishna is, do you want to become Gopika Nandakaha, the sword which slashes the gopis to death? Then they asked the Priyala tree. The Priyal is also known as Chiranji in Hindi. Then they asked the Panas or jackfruit tree. And they asked the Kovidara tree. So they asked all these various fruit giving trees. Then finally they also asked the Jambu, Jamun tree. After asking these trees, they asked some other trees such as Arka, which is giant milkweed. They asked the Bilva or Bale tree. They asked the Asana or Bijasar tree. They asked the Bakula, is also known as Spanish cherry. And they asked the Kadamba, which is also known as bird flower. And they asked the Nipa, which is a variety of the palm tree. So they asked all these trees and various other trees. And the acharyas give realization on each and every name. Today, I do not have time to go into all those realizations. But more than 130 realizations are given by Sri Hari Suri himself for each and every name of each and every tree. After they were exhausted asking the trees, they said, they thought in their hearts, these trees, it seems that these trees are not willing to give us any answer. But let us ask some other living entities. Let us ask the earth, because it is said in Shastra that the earth is a wife of Bhagavan. So we will ask the earth where he is. Because even though he is hidden from us, his feet will still be touching her. So she will tell us certainly where Krishna is. So they asked the earth as to where Krishna has gone. And when they received no reply from the earth, then they asked the female deers, the does. And here the acharyas say that, oh, Mrigi, O doe, you are always with Krishna Mriga. You are always with the black buck, with the black deer. Why don't you also give us the same good fortune of being with the Krishna Mriga, the play toy of us gopis named Krishna? So in this way they asked the female deers. And after asking, when they did not receive any reply, and the gopis became maddened in their ecstasies, their separation. So what Shukdev Goswami was describing earlier happens now. And Shukdev Goswami starts describing it, that the gopis became bewildered in their vain search for Krishna. And their hearts became so absorbed in Krishna, as if they felt that we are identical with Krishna. They began to emulate Krishna's divine pastimes. So one of the gopis, she, you know, started sucking the breast of another gopi, as if, you know, she was Krishna and the other gopi was Putana. And one gopi, she put her two hands and two feet on the ground and she stood like a cart. And another gopi acted as baby Krishna and kicked that gopi, and that gopi turned over and fell down. And they imitated the cart pastime of Krishna. Then another gopi took the role of the demon Trinavarta and carried away another gopi in her arms, and she rolled her around. And another gopi started crawling on 4 feet and started making a noise of her anklets, as if it was baby Krishna who was, you know, roaming around in Gokula. Two gopis took the role of Krishna and Balaram. And another gopi took the role of Vatsasur, who had come in the form of a calf, a demon. And another gopi took the role of Bakasur. Another gopi took the role of Krishna, who was calling out to cows. Hey, Padme! Oh, Padma! So, in this way, you know, one of the gopis took the role of Krishna, and that Krishna was calling out to various cows. Ai Nandini, O Nandini. Padmagandhe, O Padmagandha. In this way, a gopi started imitating Krishna's calling out to the cows. So then, another gopi, you know, she took a piece of cloth on her hand and she said, "Don't fear Indra's rainfall. I'm holding Govardhan for the Govardhan hill on the, you know, smallest finger of my left hand." So in this way, the gopis were imitating the pastimes of Krishna. So this imitation was going on. And another gopi said, "You know, I will extinguish the forest fire. Please close your eyes." Another gopi, you know, tied a gopi to a mortar, and then she took the role of Yashoda, and, you know, then she showed Krishna the other gopi the stick. So in this way, they were imitating the pastimes of Krishna. But then amongst all the trees and creepers and earth and deers that they had asked, finally Bhu Devi, goddess earth, came to their rescue. And suddenly they noticed footprints of Krishna on the earth. So the earth finally gave a hint. Krishna wanted to hide, but the earth gave away Krishna's secrets. And definitely when the earth gave Krishna's secrets, at that time the gopis saw those footprints and they understood, because those footprints had the mark of a flag, a lotus, you know, a thunderbolt, and various other marks which are present on Krishna's lotus feet. Then they started tracing the path, and the gopis started talking amongst themselves. With whom did Krishna go? Who is that fortunate lady? Whose footprints are there along with Krishna's footprints? Because they saw another set of footprints with Krishna's. And then they started tracing those footprints. So initially they saw two set of footprints, and they understood that Krishna had gone along with some gopi to a secret place. And then after some time, they saw, you know, only one set of footprints, because they said the footprints of the lady are no longer visible. But they saw one set of footprints, and those one set of footprints were Krishna's footprints. And these footprints were further pressed into the ground. So they understood that these footprints are further pressed into the ground. It means something must have happened. That our Krishna must have been carrying this fortunate gopi. Certainly, our Krishna must have been carrying this gopi. So, when the gopis were thinking like this, then at that point of time, the gopis said that certainly this gopi is a special gopi. And this is the verse, dear devotees, where Shukadev Goswami's ecstasy reaches at its highest point because he wants to speak the name of that gopi. But as he is speaking the name of this gopi, he realizes that I should not speak it directly, because this gopi is the guru of the guru of the guru of my guru. My guru is Vyasadev. Vyasadev's guru is Narad. Narad's guru is Brahma. Brahma's guru is Krishna. And Krishna's guru is this gopi, Srimati Radharani. So I should not speak this gopi's name directly. Atma nama guru or nama namati kripanasya cha shreyas kamo nagrihini yad jeshthapatya kalatraya. A person who desires benefit should never speak his guru's name. So, Shri Shukadev Goswami indirectly said, Anaya radhito nunam bhagavan haririshwarah yanno vihaya govindah prito yamanayadrah. Anaya aradhito nunam. Certainly, this power particular gopi has perfectly worshipped the all powerful personality of Godhead Govinda. Since he was so pleased with her that he abandoned the rest of us and brought her to a secluded place. So here, Radhita is an indicator of Srimati Radharani. And all the Gaudiya Vaishnava commentators have indicated this fact very clearly in their commentaries, that here the gopi being referred to is none other than Srimati Radharani. So when that happened, the commentators, they, you know, do not leave any stone unturned in bringing out the name of Srimati Radharani. So the gopis, they tried to find this gopi. they went inside the forest and they started thinking what must have happened. And they thought that, you know, this gopi must have asked Krishna to carry her, and Krishna must have, you know, said, okay, I will carry you. So, you know, I will bend down, you just climb on my shoulders. And when Krishna, you know, bent down and Srimati Radharani was about to climb on his shoulder, Krishna must have disappeared. So they searched for her, and then they came to that location where only Srimati Radharani was there. And then she narrated everything, all these details to them. And Srimati Radharani was crying there under the moonlight. The commentators severely chastised the moon for hiding Krishna under broad moonlight, under full moonlight. He hid Krishna. Sri Hari Suri goes ahead and chastises the moon through the words of Srimati Radharani. He says, you know, in any decent family, when the juniors become eligible for marriage, the elders should take his hand and place his hand in the hands of a suitable wife. But, O moon, you are so shameless that even though a junior in your family, because Krishna was born in the moon dynasty, is eligible for marriage, you are purposely hiding him from us. Certainly, you have no pratishtha in society. Pratishtha means prestige. Pratishtha also means fixed position. You have no fixed position because you always keep failing. So in this way, the Acharyas constantly chastise the moon for hiding Krishna. Sri Hari Suri also composes another verse to specify that it was Srimati Radharani, nobody else. Gurvanganeyamiti mamavagatya mohat kimre karai sprishasi chandra nirastalajjam tarana kama mahamachyuta pada sakta saradhiketya lamalam kila sahasena. Shri Hari Suri says Srimati Radharani was looking at the moon and saying, Gurvanganeyam, don't think that I am Guru Angana, the wife of your Guru Brihaspati. Because historically there was an incident where the moon, he forcibly enjoyed with the wife of his own Guru Brihaspati, whose name was Tara. So it's described in the Srimad Bhagavatam that the moon one time forcibly enjoyed with his guru's wife, Brihaspati's wife Tara. So Radharani is saying, Gurvanganeyam, don't think that I am Guru Angana. One meaning of Guru Angana is she who has broad hips. Another meaning of Guru Angana is she who is the guru's wife. Don't think I am Guru Angana. Iti mam avagatya mohat, don't come near me out of illusion. Kim re karai sprishasi, why are you touching me with your karas? One meaning of kara is rays. Another meaning of kara is hands. Why are you touching me with your hands? O chandra nirasta lajjam, O shameless moon. Tara nakama maham, I am not Tara. You know, I am not that Tara, the wife of Brihaspati. Aham achyuta pada sakta, I am firmly attached to the lotus feet of Achyuta. And because of that, sa radhika iti, I am sa radhika, I am that radhika. Another meaning is, I am sara adhika, I am very powerful. So don't come near me, don't dare to come near me. Iti alam alam kila sahasena, stop right now, moon. So in this way, it's a very chastising statement. Oh, shameless moon, thinking that I am Guru Angana, wife of Brihaspati or broad-waisted girl. You are trying to touch me with your kara, hands or rays. Beware, I am not Tara, Brihaspati's wife or the stars, who is Achyuta Pada Sakta, residing in the sky. But I am that Achyuta Pada Sakta, attached to Achyuta's feet. And hence I am Sa Radhika, that Radhika, or Sara Adhika, or she who has extreme strength. Alam alam kila sahasena, stop, do not dare to touch me. In this way, she threatened the moon. This is the Acharya's, you know, vision in their samadhi. Finally, Sri Hari Suri says, the gopis decided, either you show us Swakanana or show us Swakanana. One meaning is Swakanana, Swa means your, Kanana means forest. Either you show us your forest, it means you disappear and you never come in front of us. Or you show us Svaka Anana, your Anana, your face. But in both cases, Krishna, we will never leave you. We are not going to leave you. So all the gopis sat down there. They came to the banks of the Yamuna because they wanted to go ahead, but it was getting too dark. And the forest was getting even more dense. So the moon's rays were not reaching that part of the forest. So they didn't go ahead. They came back to the banks of the Yamuna. They sat down. And on the banks of the Yamuna, all the gopis, they started singing the Gopi Gita. So this, dear devotees, here begins the 31st chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam. We see our Krishna is hiding behind and the gopis are singing Gopi Gita. He is hiding right there. Taddure tadvantike. That is what he is. So the gopis, they were singing Gopi Gita on the banks of the Yamuna and Krishna was hiding behind. And Sri Jiva Goswami, says, you know, Krishna is Paropadesha Panditaha. He is expert only in giving advice to others. Expert only in giving suggestions and free advice, unsolicited advice to others. When the gopis came to him, he started giving them unsolicited advice. Why have you come? You should serve your husbands. Go back to your homes. It's not proper to stay here. But who asked you? In the Bhagavad Gita, you didn't open your mouth until Arjun became your disciple. But when it came to the gopis, you started giving instructions without any, you know, without being prompted to do so. Paropadesha Pandit, O false guru, did anybody ask you to give these instructions? And now you are hiding away. You ran away yourselves. So we don't need such a false guru. But the gopis, they were in their own mood. They started singing this gopi geet in order to attract Krishna. So this gopi geet is 19 verses. The first 18 verses being in a meter, in a different meter. With the main name of the meter is Kanaka Manjari. So the first 18 verses are in the meter named Kanaka Manjari. And the 19th verse is in the meter Vasant Tilakam. So these 19 verses are known as Gopi Geeta. So the first verse is as follows. Gopya uchuhu jayati tedhikam janmana vraja shrayata indira shashvadatrahi daita drishyatam dikshutavakas tvaidhritasavas tvam vichinvate. So the gopi said, jayati te dhikam janmana vraja. The gopi said, jayati, you know, this vraja is jayati. It has become most superior. It was already superior. The devotees were already superior. Even before you took birth, it was already superior. Why was vraja superior? And in whose comparison was vraja superior to? So vraja was already superior to Vaikuntha. Why? Because in Vaikuntha, you know, there are, Krishna never takes birth. But in vraja, Krishna takes birth. In Vaikuntha, we never celebrate Narayan's appearance. But in vraja, we celebrate Krishna's appearance. So, jayati te dhikam janmana vraja. Vraja is already glorious. But by your taking birth, it has become even more glorious. Adhikam jayati. And see the contrast with Vaikuntha. Shrayata indrira shashvadatrahi. In Vaikuntha, Lakshmi is served, but Indira Shashvadatrahi Shrayate. But here in Vrindavan, Lakshmi Devi constantly serves. O Daita Drishyatam Dikshutavaka. O Daita, O Lord, you know, please reveal yourself. Drishyatam. Why? Because we beloveds, we with great difficulty, we are alive. And we are searching for you in every direction. Dikshu, in all directions we are searching for you. In the next verse, the gopis say, Sharadudashaye sadhu jatasat sarasi jodara shri mushadrisha suratanathate shulkadasika वरद निघ्नतो नेह किं वदः. So in the next verse the gopis say, Suratanath, O Lord of amorous enjoyment, neha kim vadah, are you not slaughtering us on a mass scale? You are slaughtering us on a mass scale actually. You are arranging the combined slaughter of all of us gopis by disappointing us, your maid servants. Because you have these eyes, you know, which steal the splendor of a full-blown lotus of the autumn season. But still, you are not appearing in front of us. And by not appearing in front of us, what you are doing instead is you are killing us en masse. So please don't kill us. And, you know, Krishna may say at this point of time, well, my intention is to kill you. Certainly, my intention is to kill you. I don't want you to stay alive. Well, if that is the purpose, then the gopis say the next verse. Vishajalaphyayad vyalarakshasad varshamarutad vaidyutanalat vrishamayatmajad vishvatobhayat rishabhatevayam rakshitamuhu. So if that is the case, why did you rescue us from so many dangers in the past? If your intention was to kill us, then why did you rescue us from so many dangers? What were the dangers? We have been protected from death through drinking of poisonous water, Vishajala Pyayad, Vyala Rakshasad, from Aghasur. Vyala means Aghasur and Rakshasat means from other demons. And Varshamarutad, from heavy showers, stormy winds, Vaidyutanalat, and from lightning bolts, Vrishamayatmajat, from the demon Aristasur, and Vishvato Bhayat, and from all other types of fears. So why are you so indifferent to us? Because we still hope that you will give us your protection. No? Then Krishna may say, but you know, but people say that I am just a small young boy in Vrindavan. I am Yashoda's son. So then the gopis say, no, no. Nakhalu gopika nandano bhavan akhila dehina mantaratmadrik vikhana sarthito vishwa guptaye sakha udeivan satvatam kule. So, Nakhalu Gopika Nandano Bhavan. You're not only Gopika Nandana, not only the son of Yashoda, but Akhila Dehinam Antaratmadrik. You are the super soul in the hearts of each and everyone. Vikhanasa Arthito. Brahma prayed for you to appear. For what? Vishwa Gupta, protecting the entire world. We are also part of this entire world. You won't protect us. No. You want us to die. Brahma called you for protecting the entire world. And you want us to die. But Sakha Udeyivan Satvatam Kuli, you're born in the Satvata dynasty for protecting the entire world. So you should also protect us. So, in this way, the gopis are singing. The commentators have taken many twists and turns on every verse. You know. So, they take na khalu, you are not Gopika Nandana. You know, you are not the son of Yashoda. If you were the son of Yashoda, you would not be so cruel. Yashoda was never so cruel to us. Then they take na khalu and apply it to the next line. Na khalu akhila dehina mantra. You are not the super soul in everyone's heart. If you were the super soul in everyone's heart, you would have understood what pain we are going through. Na khalu vikhana sarthito vishwa guptaye. We don't think that Brahma prayed for you to come and rescue the earth because you are killing us now. Na khalu udeivan satvatam kule. We don't think you are really born in the Satvata dynasty because the Vrishnis are protectors of the surrendered. But you do not protect the people who have surrendered unto you. So the acharyas have played a lot on each and every verse. But unfortunately today we do not have the time to go through each and every realization. But still, we'll go ahead and see the verses. So, in the next verse, the gopis say, विरचिताभयं वृष्णिधुर्यते चरणमीयुषां संसृतेर्भयात् करसरोरुहं कान्तकामदं शिरसि देहिना शीकरग्रहम्। विरचित अभयम वृष्णि धूर्यते, ओ लॉर्ड ऑफ द वृष्णीज, ओ बेस्ट अमंग्स द वृष्णीज, विरचित अभयम ते चरणम ईयुषाम संस्कृतेर भयात्। दोज हु टुक शेल्टर ऑफ योर लोटस फीट, यू एंश्योर्ड दैट दे रिसीव अभय चरण, दे रिसीव फियरलेसनेस एट योर लोटस फीट, फियरलेसनेस फ्रॉम दिस मटीरियल वर्ल्ड। सो प्लीज यू नो डू वन थिंग, कर सरोरुहम योर लोटस हैंड्स कांत कामदम विच इंक्रीज द लस्ट इन द हार्ट्स ऑफ अस गोपीस, शिरसि देहिना कीप इट ऑन आवर हेड्स, श्री करग्रहम दिस हैंड विच वॉज टच्ड बाय द हैंड्स ऑफ लक्ष्मी देवी। अनदर इज श्री करग्रहम दिस हैंड विच वॉज लास्ट टच्ड बाय श्रीमती राधारानी। नेक्स्ट द गोपी से व्रज जनार्ति हन वीर योषिताम निज जन स्मय ध्वंसन स्मित भज सखे भवत किंकरि स्मनो जलरुहाननम चारु दर्शय। सो दे से यू नो ओ माइटी हीरो, यू आर व्रज जनार्ति हन, यू आर द अनाइहिलेटर ऑफ द अफ्लिक्शंस ऑफ द इनहैबिटेंट्स ऑफ व्रज। निज जनस्मय धन सनस्मित, योर स्माइल ह्यूमिलिएट्स द प्राइड ऑफ योर ओन पीपल व्हेन दे बिकम प्राउड। सो ऑफ कोर्स यू आर स्माइलिंग नाउ बिकॉज योर स्माइल डिफीटेड आवर प्राइड, बट एटलीस्ट शो दैट स्माइल टू अस, शो अस योर लोटस फेस, प्लीज शो अस दैट लोटस फेस, प्लीज शो अस दैट स्माइल विच इज टेलिंग अस दैट यू हैव डिफीटेड आवर प्राइड। Then the gopis, you know, then Krishna may say that, you know, but if I appear in front of you and enjoy with you, then there will be fear of irreligiosity, you know, and there may be fear of lust rising up in your heart, the poisonous lust rising in your hearts. So the gopis say in reply, Pranat dehinam pap karshanam तृणचरानुगम श्रीनिकेतनम फणिफणार्पितम ते पदाम्बुजम कृणुकुचेषु नः कृन्धिहृच्छयम्। प्रणत देहिनाम पापकर्षणम, यू नो टोटली अनाइलेट द सिंस ऑफ दोज हु सरेंडर योर सेल्फ एट योर लोटस फीट। सो हाउ कैन देयर बी एनी पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ अस being affected by sin if we enjoy with you? You know, your lotus feet are trinacharanugam, they follow the cows, you know, the various herbivorous animals in the forest, and these lotus feet, you know, if you feel that our hearts are, you know, poisoned with lust, please place these feet on our hearts just like you place them on Kaliya's woods. You drove away the poison of Kaliya by placing your feet on his foot. So please place the same feet on our chests and drive away the poison of lust within our hearts. So in this way, the gopis are praying to Bhagavan. Then in the next verse, they say, Madhuraya gira valgu vakyaya बुध मनोज्ञया पुष्करे क्षण विधि करीरिमा वीर मुह्यतीर अधर सीधुना प्याययस्वन। मधुरया गिरा वल्गु वाक्यया, ओ लोटस आइड लॉर्ड विथ योर मेलोडियस वर्ड्स, मधुरया गिरा वल्गु वाक्यया विथ योर इक्विवोकल चार्मिंग एक्सप्रेशंस, बुध मनोज्ञया विच आर वेरी अपीलिंग to the minds of the wise, O Pushkarekshana, O lotus-eyed Lord, you know, with your with the adhara sidhuna, with the nectar of your lips. Please revive us, you know, because we are burning in our hearts. You put fire. You are an arsonist who put fire to our hearts. So please, with the nectar of your lips, you know, please extinguish that fire. So Krishna may ask, if you are burning in your hearts because of separation, then why are you still alive even though I am away from you? So in reply to this, the gopis say, we are alive only because of one thing. Tava kathamritam tapte jivanam kavibhiriditam kalmashapaham shravana mangalam shrimadatatam bhuvi grinantiye bhuridajana. Because just like you have six qualities, Bhagavan has six qualities, your katha also has six qualities. Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam kavibhiriditam kalmashapaham shravana mangalam shrimadatatam. Six qualities. Tava katha amritam, your katha is nectar. Tapta jivanam, for, and it immediately extinguishes the burning sensations of life. Kavibhiriditam, your nectarian disc, your katha is glorified by the selected poets. Kalmashapaham, your katha drives away all sin. Shravana mangalam, your katha is very pious for the ears, all auspicious for the ears. Shri madatatam, and it brings all good fortune. So these six qualities, just as you have six qualities, your katha also has six qualities. Bhuvi grinantiye, those who speak this katha, Guridajana, they are most magnanimous people on the surface of this planet Earth. So in this way, so then the gopis come back, you know, and they again start describing, because they don't want to go to katha, they want to again ask Krishna for presenting himself. So they again start singing. Prahasitam priya prema vikshanam viharanam chate dhyana mangalam rahasi samvido yahriti sprisha kuhakano mana shobhayantihi. So they say, prahasitam priya, you are smiling. Priya prema vikshanam, you are looking at us with love. Viharanam, you are roaming around with us. Dhyana mangalam, our meditation on you, your sweet remembrances, all auspicious remembrances. Rahasi samvido, our talks in, you know, a secluded place. Ya hridi sprisha, you know, which touched our hearts. Kuhaka, oh cheater, no manah kshobayanti, now they are agitating our hearts. They are completely agitating our hearts. Then they again describe how their minds are being agitated, why their minds are being agitated. So they say, chalasi yad vrajai charayan pashun nalina sundaram nathate padam shilatrinankurai sidatitinah kalilatam manah kanta gachati. So, you know, they say, oh loving Lord, oh Kanta, when, you know, you go out of Raja to graze cattle, our heart becomes agitated. Why? Because your lotus-like beautiful feet will be pricked by the gravel, by the, you know, sharp blades of grass, by the stones. Therefore, our hearts are agitating. These feet are not, you know, you should not, this ground is not worthy of your feet being placed upon it. Your feet should be placed on some other soft object. So, in this way, the gopis are describing how they are agitated. Once again, they describe Krishna and the remembrance of Krishna, especially in the evening time when he comes back after grazing all the cows. दिन परीक्षये नीलकुन्तलैर् वनरुहाननं बिभ्रदावृतं घनरजस्वलं दर्शयन्मुहुर् मनसि नः स्मरं वीरयच्छसि. दिन परीक्षये एट द एंड ऑफ द डे इन द इवनिंग एंड यू कम बैक नीलकुन्तलैर् यू नो विथ योर ब्लूइश डार्क ब्लू कर्ली हेयर वनरुहाननं योर लोटस फेस Bibhradavritam is completely surrounded by this, you know, curly bluish hair. Ghana Rajasvalam, and these hair are containing particles of dust raised by the cows. Darshayan, and when you show this face to us, Muhur Manasi Nahasmaram Virayachasi, you agitate the lust within our heart. You activate the cupid within our heart. So in this way, the gopis were remembering Krishna. And therefore, the gopis said, since you have agitated the lust in our hearts, therefore you should satisfy this lust. You should place your lotus feet on our chest. And this is what the gopis pray in the next verse. Pranata kamadam padmajarchitam धरणि मंडनम ध्येयमापदि चरण पंकजम शंतमं चते रमण नस्तनेश्वर पयाधिहन. सो प्रणत कामदम, एक्चुअली यू सैटिस्फाई ऑल द डिजायर्स यू नो ऑफ दोज हु हैव सरेंडर्ड टू यू, दोज हु बाउ डाउन टू यू. यू आर बिग एंचेंटर यू आर. Please place your lotus feet, you know, on our chest. Because these lotus feet are the very ornament of earth. Please, please place these lotus feet on our breasts. In this way, the gopis were praying for Krishna to place his lotus feet on their chest. Then the gopis again wanted to taste the nectar of Krishna's lips. Adharamritam. So the gopis prayed, Surata Vardhanam Shokanashanam Swarita Venuna Sushtu Chumbitam Itara Ragave Smaranam Dranam Vitara Virana Stedharamritam. Te Adharamritam, your lower lip nectar, is Surata Vardhanam. It increases the lust, the desires in our heart. Shokanashanam, it destroys all lamentation. Swarita Venuna Sushtu Chumbitam, and this flute, it has thoroughly relished this nectar. Itara Raga Vismaranam, and this nectar of your lower lip makes us forget attachment to everything else. Dranam Vitara Viranas, please distribute, arrange a big food for life counter and distribute your Adharamrita, your lower lip nectar to us. Sri Sanatan Goswami says lower lip nectar also means your sweet words. Come and make us hear some of your sweet words. Come speak to us. You know, come please come and speak to us. So in this way. Then the gopis describe, you know, they are gradually moving into the stage of Mahabhav. So what is happening is that they are describing that in separation from you, even one small moment becomes like a big yuga. That's what they say. Atati yad bhavan ahni kananam tritiyugayate tvam apashyatam kutila kuntalam shrimukham chate jada udikshatam pakshmakridrisham. So during daytime, Krishna, when you are away wandering in the woods, we are not able to see you. So truti, even a quarter of a moment, yuga, it becomes like a yuga, you know. But when you return back in the evening and when we are gazing at you, we feel that, you know, Brahma is dull-witted. He's not intelligent in creating our eyes, because he made eyelashes, and while winking for a moment, We are deprived of your beautiful sight and your curly locks of hair. So in this way, the gopis are describing that when you're away from us, even a small fraction of a moment becomes like a big yuga in separation. And when you come in front of us also, there is that fraction of a moment of separation, even when you're present. And who has arranged that? That is Brahma has done that because our eyes blink. When our eyes blink, for a fraction of a moment, there is separation. So that fraction also turns into a yuga for us. It's very apt poetic description of separation. Very nice. So then the gopis, they start cursing Krishna. Pati sutanvaya bhratribandhavan ati vilanghyate intyachyutagata gati vidastavod gita mohita kitava yoshita kastya jenishi. Oh kitava, oh big cheater. Pati suta anvaya bhratra bandhavan, we gave up our husband, our children, our family members, relatives, well-wishers, friends. Ati vilanghya, we overpowered them. We were obstinate, we didn't listen to their orders. And achyuta agataha, and we came near you. Gati vidas tava udgita mohita. And we were completely enchanted by your gita, by your playing on the flute. Actually, you called us here. And after calling us here, kastya jen nishi, who will suddenly desert, who will suddenly, ghost upon the ladies who have approached you in the middle of the night. So Krishna, you ghosted us. Suddenly you left us. So this is what the gopis are, cursing out. Then the gopis again, start remembering those pastimes with him because they are becoming more and more overwhelmed with bhava, mahabhava. So they say, rahasi samvidam richayodayam prahasitananam prema vikshanam brihadura shriyo vikshadhamate muhurati spriha muhyate mana. So then they say, when we remember your secret amorous promises and beholding your smiling face, which provokes the passion in our heart, your loving glances and your broad chest, Brihadura Shriyo. This chest is the residence of Lakshmi Devi. Our hearts become inflamed with longing every now and then. We become infatuated. Please come back, Krishna. Please come back. The 18th verse, they say, Rajavanaukasam vyaktirangate vrijana hantrialam vishwamangalam tyajamanakchana stvatsprihatmanam svajana hridrujam yanshudanam. So they say, oh darling Krishna, your incarnation is for dispelling the miseries of the inhabitants of Vraja, Gopas, and of the sages, and for bestowing highest auspiciousness on the universe. Therefore, please, we are yearning for you. Please bestow us with your company and please relieve us of the anguish, of separation from you. Please do that. Finally, the gopis attain Mahabhav. Some gopis attain Adhirud Mahabhav. Some gopis attain Modanakhya Mahabhav. Srimati Radharani attains Madanakhya Mahabhav, the final stage of Mahabhav. And then they loudly cry out, Yatte sujat charanam buruham staneshu bhita shanai priyatadhi mahikarikasheshu te natavim atasitad vyathate na kim swit kurpadivir bhramati dhir bhavadayusham naha. Oh dearly beloved, your lotus feet are so soft that we place them gently on our breasts, fearing that your feet will be hurt. Our life rests only in you. Our minds are filled with anxiety that your tender feet might be wounded by pebbles as you roam about on the forest path. So in this way, the gopis say to Krishna, please come back and place your feet on our chest. And when this doesn't work, then the gopis start crying out loudly in the forest. Loudly they cry out in the forest. And the commentator, Sri Hari Suri, says that Vividhar Javitan Tadrik, you know, all other processes of sadhana, singing for Krishna, dancing for Krishna, you know, chanting Krishna's names, do not work as effectively as crying for Krishna. The most effective process for attaining Krishna is crying for Krishna. What is the proof? The proof is that the best devotees in the universe, the gopis also, when Krishna had disappeared, they sang, they danced, they roamed here and there, they chanted his names, but nothing worked. Finally, Krishna became pleased only when the gopis cried out loudly for them. Dear devotees, please remember that the best way of bringing Krishna back into our hearts, into our lives, into our wretched existence in this material world is to cry out loudly for Krishna as the gopis cried out. So with this, dear devotees, the 31st chapter ends. And tomorrow we will continue from the point where Krishna appears again. So thank you very much once again, dear devotees. Yadatra skhalitam kinchit vidvam sahapura yantu tat. Yadatra saushtavam kinchit tad guru reva me nahi. Yadatra skhalitam kinchit. If there was any mistake, you know, obviously there have been many mistakes in my speaking. But vidvam sah, you are all learned devotees. Purayantu tat, you please complete all of those mistakes. But yadatra saushtavam kinchit, if there was anything nice, a single sentence, a single word, half a word, you know, or half a syllable, if it was nice, please remember, tad guru reva, it belongs to my gurujanas, me nahi, it doesn't belong to me. So thank you very much once again, dear devotees. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Parshad Prabhu. Thank you very much again. This beautiful narration of both these chapters. I know you could probably speak a whole class on each of these verses, and we've somehow requested you to put two chapters together. We have a couple questions, if you're still willing to take them.
Sure, sure.
First of all, we have Kuladri Prabhu. Our dear Kuladri Prabhu, who is asking, please recommend accepted audios. Give me one second. Accepted audiobooks, tapes, sharing Krishna Leela and Eternal Personalities in the Madhurya, Vatsalya, Sakya, Dasya, and Shantarasas.
Okay. So please recommend accepted audiobooks and tapes. So audiobooks, I'm not sure how many there are, but there are many books of our acharyas in the Sampradaya, such as Gopal Champuhu, Anand Vrindavan Champu. And if somebody has higher adhikar, higher eligibility, they can also go for higher books such as Krishna Bhavanamrita, Govinda Leelamritam, etc. So Shantaras is not accepted in our Sampradaya. Shantaras is discarded in the Sampradaya. So therefore we are not named, you know, like Hari Parshad Shanta. Our Sampradaya begins with Dasya Ras. So we call Hari Parshad Das. So Mahaprabhu came only to give four rasas. So we begin with Dasya Ras. And all these four rasas are beautifully described in Gopal Champu and other literature of the acharyas of our Sampradaya. So we can relish all this literature. Rupa Goswami's Dan Keli Kaumudi, or Raghunath Das Goswami's Dan Keli Chintamani, or so many literature are there. It is endless, but I don't know how many are there in audiobook, because every literature, these verses have, you have to sit down with every verse and see the secrets behind every verse. So it's not simply some translation, but somebody should do a transcreation of the verses. somebody should transcreate the verses in the English language with all the secrets. So if that is possible, then we will truly be able to relish these works. That is the answer.
For that, we need scholars like yourself that are deeply fixed in devotion. Prabhu, so just are those books available in English language, or they're mostly in, like,
they're
some of them I know they are.
But yeah, they're available in, their English translations are available. But, you know, my recommendation is always, because many of them are translations, but the secrets are not told in many of those translations. So my recommendation is to study them with somebody who can read the commentaries and find out the hidden meanings behind the verses.
We have to become fortunate enough for that.
I'll just give a simple example. When Krishna is leaving from Vrindavan to go to Mathura, he's on Akrura's chariot. The gopis come and say that, you know, you didn't give us any gift till now. So can you give us one last gift? So Krishna says, what gift? The gopis say, when you go to Mathura, send us a gift of 3 palms of water. So although then that's it. But the hidden meaning is that 3 palms of water are oblation waters which are sent only to the dead. And it indirectly indicates that the gopis will be dead. So you could not give us anything while we were alive. At least give us a gift of 3 palms of water after we die. So these secrets have to be studied with commentaries so that we can understand the exact intention of the acharyas.
So in the same line, there is a devotee here asking, all glories to Guru and Gauranga, all glories to you. It would be merciful of you if you could guide where we can get this most amazing Bhagavatam commentary, Pad Harishori. Please guide.
Well, I myself was searching for so many years. After I heard it first from my Guru Maharaj, like a blind man, I was searching. After many years, I got access to one copy and I digitized it, but it was completely in Sanskrit. So some attempt is being made by myself to recreate it in the English language. I don't know how successful I will be, but if the devotees pray for me, then maybe in a year or 2 years, I'll try to bring out the first volume of Sri Harishuri's Bhakti Rasayanam. So let's see how that goes.
So from what I knew, that you have already worked on the first chapter. Is it in English or in Hindi?
I've done 6 chapters in Hindi already.
Okay.
So when 7 chapters are done, I'll try to bring out the first volume. And then devotees who speak Hindi will be able to speak it out to others. But obviously, I'll also bring it out in English.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your wonderful service, Prabhu. It's much needed. Because you're relishing this wonderful nectar that Sripad Harishwari has, and you're giving us a few drops here and there, and we're feeling like quenched, somebody that has promised us nectar. So we're eagerly waiting for that composition of yours. Thank you, Prabhu. There is one other question. Our scriptures give detailed esoteric descriptions of rasa with Krishna. What are the sections of our scriptures one should read if someone has affinity towards the other 4 kind of rasas? I think you clarified that Shantarasa does not even exist in a sampradaya. It seems not much is available to read and hear. Also, we are all followers of Rupa Goswami. Does that mean that our hearts would naturally be inclined towards conjugal rasa?
So we are naturally followers of Srila Rupa Goswami. So if we are Rupanuga, so then our heart should naturally flow in the direction of Madhurya Ras. But just because we are in the Diksha Pranali of Rupa Goswami doesn't mean that our hearts cannot be affected by other rasas. Some devotees may be affected by other rasas, and there is enough literature for the other rasas also. So there is Prayo Bhakti Rasaranava, literature for Sakhya Ras. So there is Vatsalya Lilamritam for Vatsalya Ras. Many literature are there, but these are some rare literature. And there is Padavali Kirtan Bengali kirtan, more than 10,000 Bengali kirtans, you know, we're celebrating each and every rasa. So devotees should at least learn Bengali and learn how to sing the kirtans. But then they can relish all the rasas nicely. Hare Krishna.
Beautiful. Also, Prabhu, here you mentioned the different meters you've been mentioning and singing. Where can devotees read more information about them or learn about those meters and how to use them appropriately?
Yeah, in my childhood, I learned a book named Shrutabodh by Kalidas. This was the first book which introduces meters, Shrutabodh by Kalidas. It's a Sanskrit book, but it introduced the science of Sanskrit metrics to me. And from there were more advanced literature. Like I also studied Chando Manjari of Gangadas Pandit. Gangadas Pandit was the grammar teacher of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So I studied from Chando Manjari of Gangadas Pandit. So I learned from the teacher of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Yeah, wonderful. Perfectly aligned. Thank you. Thank you so much, Prabhu, for sharing your wisdom and being so available. We're eagerly looking forward to the next two chapters, and we're hoping that there will be a time where we will have no restriction of time and we can hear all of these verses in depth and really meditate on these beautiful verses and try to understand what these esoteric pastimes really are. Thank you so much again, Prabhu. Thank you so much to all our viewers for joining us today, for joining us for the past whole month. We are going to again have a session with Hari Parshad Prabhu tomorrow, where he will be covering the next two chapters of the Rasa Dance. Please join us again and feel free to, you know, think about your questions. Prabhu has been very kind to take all his questions, comments. We get really inspired when we receive your messages about how inspired you are by this series. So take a moment, write to us with your suggestions, your comments. Please subscribe and to our mailing list at gbcsbt.com. We have Shyamasakhi Devi flashing it on our screen right now. And write to us with any suggestions and comments you have. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us again. Thank you so much, Hari Parshad Prabhu.
Thank you so much. Jai Shila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna.
Jai Shila Prabhupada.